Contracting out your wide area network services to a Layer 3 VPN provider is definitely a leap of faith. While you can create service level agreements that penalize the provider should they fail to perform to your satisfaction, any outages of critical services can end up costing more in productivity loss or customer satisfaction than the SLA covers. Have you ever found yourself blaming connectivity issues on your VPN provider, only to have them point their fingers back at you? Wouldn't it be great if you could provide detailed information supporting your side of these finger-pointing battles? In the following vignettes, we have identified three short examples of how the Route Explorer MPLS WAN product can be used to help reduce the finger-pointing. In this first video, a customer has recently switched to connecting 5 regional networks over a provider's MPLS VPN service. I'll go ahead and log in to the Route Explorer web UI and bring up the live network. After logging in, you can see the 5 separate regions being monitored. Everything has been pretty smooth in the process of outsourcing this customer's WAN, and the only issues have been some intermittent connection slowness between the Chicago and New York offices. The deployment was done using a full mesh design, so each site should have a direct path to every other site. We can go through testing this using path highlighting between routers in each of the sites. No problems appear except when we try a path between one of the Chicago routers and a New York router. When we do this, something odd happens. We see that traffic is being routed from Chicago to a CE router in Los Angeles, and then finally on to New York. Obviously, this isn't per design and would be more prone to failures due to the extra hops or application degradation simply because the data is traveling 3 to 4 times farther than necessary. Drilling in on the path shows that the Chicago routers don't know how to reach the loopback addresses of the routers in New York, and the less specific 10.0/8 route being announced out of the LA CE is being used as an intermediate hop in the path to the New York site. A quick test using the CLI on one of the Chicago routers verified that the traffic was indeed being routed through the LA CE router. After reporting the problem to the provider of the MPLS VPN service, routing returned to the expected as-designed configuration. While it's not necessary to understand what the provider did, in this particular instance, a single line in the BGP VPN configuration had been omitted on the route reflector server of the Chicago PE router. Telling this route reflector server that the Chicago PE router was a route reflector client cleared up the issue. Because performance data was being collected between the CE routers, we can also look at the SLA data from the Chicago CE routers to the New York routers. When I bring up the strip chart showing a couple days worth of SLA data, it is obvious that the change has made a noticeable difference in latency delays and jitter between the two sites. There are 2 key takeaways from this situation. First is the amount of trust that is placed in the VPN provider. Not only must they have the necessary level of competence to run a complex network, but also have excellent process controls for reliably connecting customers to their network. This highlights why having a trust but verify philosophy for managing VPN providers can be essential. And the second takeaway is the fact that the customer had configured everything correctly, and yet there was clearly something wrong. Does this make sense? Can you see how having quick access to point-and-click path highlighting can help isolate routing problems and speed up the resolution of network issues and avoid the costly finger-pointing?